You actually turned over in 1993, and as I understand, your mother didn't really like you boxing. She wanted to hold you back.
No, my mum. It's weird. My dad like trained me every single day. He's obviously motivation and what sort of got me into boxing. Taught me how to fight. My mum was dead against it. So, yeah. Mum never watched me box once. I had like 120 amateur fights. First fight as a 10-year-old and retired at 36, 37. Never watched me once. She watched me on TV.
Yeah.
When I won, and they give her a call and say I want to fight. But it's mad, right?
Even winning your first world title, he was such a passionate man. He was such a genuinely, you know, he wore his heart on his sleeve. I mean, did you think that the titles meant more to your dad, or did they mean more to you? Was it, you know, your career all about impressing your dad?
Both of us, man. Dad was like immensely proud. Mm. And we were a team, you know, we were underdogs. And that's the thing, you know, you got a boy from the South Wales Valleys, right? Like, Italian name, but he's Welsh. Italian.
The Italian dragon.
And yeah, Italian dragon, man. And it's like, it's hard, you know. It was tough because it took a long, long time to get a following. And it's tough in boxing in Wales because even if you win the world title, you don't just get like 10,000 people come watch you. In certain cities like London, Manchester, you might get a better following in America. But over here, it was tough, you know. It was tough. I had to struggle for everything, man. And yeah, you know, and all the hard work and dedication, you know, and the faith and the commitment is all paid off, you know. And like I said, you know, me and dad were a team. And people said you should get, you know, a professional trainer or this and that. Listen, like, dad got me where I was.
Yeah.
And it worked, you know. We had our own style, we had our own technique on the training. And I got to say for my dad, though, he's like, it wasn't just because of me. He trained female champions. Don't forget, we had myself, Enzo Macronelli, Gavin Reese, and also Nathan Cleverly, because Nathan Cleverly still was trained by my dad and myself.
And Gary Lockett as well, the WBU version.
Yeah. So Gary Lockett trained at the end, but Nathan was here from a young kid, you know what I mean? So he's an outfighter. So we like that was like four world champions, you know? And plus we had Commonwealth champion in
Bradley Price.
Yeah, Bradley, Sugar Sweet.
Yeah.
Bradley Price, man, tough boy. So yeah, it was amazing times. And dad, I think, had the Ring Magazine Train of the Year 1 year, so it was great. So great times. Miss him.
Yeah. He's missed in boxing. And he wasn't just a one-hit wonder. Obviously, you were the blueprint. But as you've mentioned, he had that same recipe for success. You know, what was it about the magic, though, that... You know, I've watched the documentaries, the Calzaghe Clan. I used to watch those.
Oh, you've
know,
seen that.
From back
have
in
you
the...
Seen, yeah. You've seen my film now?
Yeah, I've seen it. Yeah. Very emotional. Very emotional. Mm. And, it was a special relationship. And they often say father and son relationships don't always work. But this was a perfect testament to that. That unison working effectively.
Yeah, listen, he's, what can I say, he's just amazing. It's amazing to be able to go and box and achieve your dreams and, you know, never lose. I mean, one of the very few fighters that don't lose, but to be able to do that with your father in your corner, it's extra special because, you know, like, we didn't have much growing up, you know, brought him to Council State and I think it was a struggle, man. You know what I mean? I was born in the 70s, man, so.
Yeah.
But it was good. It was tough love, man, you know. He'd kick my ass, get in the gym, training, a teenager, and I thank him for it, because it made me hard, and it made me a champion, made me dedicated, it made me realize never take anything for granted, always train like a challenger, never train like a champion, and to be a champion for 11 years is a long time, so to be able to train and motivate yourself, because everyone that fights you wants what you got, irrelevant of their ability, you know, if you take your eye off the ball and you take fighters for granted, just go back to like, upsets you've seen in boxing. It's hard, man. You've got to stay dedicated all the time. And sometimes, you know, you can't even get up for certain opponents or opponents pull out, but you have to keep focused and realize that, you know, that guy's trying to take away what you got. I left on my own terms. Yeah, sometimes I wish I said, I went to 50, you know, another more, couple more fights, but listen, how long do you go on? The main thing is your family and your health. And yeah, thank God I managed to have a great ride with my father, so thanks, man.
Absolutely. You know, you mentioned there as well, a lot of your achievements there, you know, you had a glittering career, people still look back on it, but aside from that, you're a family man. You know, you had a massive family, Sardinian family, they were great, they were loud, they were always you were always together, and you know, from that sense of it as well, do you look back and think, well, I had the boxing career, but I also had such a great family career as well.
Yeah, I think it was all support. I know I saw kids at a young age, which I think helped, definitely. And yeah, like I said, my father, my trainer, my mum. Yes, I think it's important, like, to have a good, obviously, family, a good base, isn't it? And have love and support. And I was sort of quite close-knit, you know what I mean? I got like a few friends I always had since I was a kid, and I'm a quite sort of private person as well, so you know, he's there.
Do you miss doing the regular media engagements? Or?
Not at all. I choose not to. Moment, I'm like I said, it's been a really, really tough year for me. Mm-hmm. Obviously, lost my father nearly a year ago now, which is difficult, man. But like I said, my boys, you know, they got the gym, you know, and it's great. You know, like I said, you know, me and my father worked so hard in this gym, so many, and it's great to keep the gym open. And like the Calzaghe Academy, so the boys are running the gym. I come down as well. And it's good. It'll be open every day soon, and you know, it's getting quite busy. And the boys got a passion for it. And,
that's great. Yeah.
And people love it, and it's really good, mate. I mean, it's good. But what was the question? The first.
Well, no, we were just talking, weren't we? But your father actually got an MBE.
Dad's got an MBE. Yeah, he had an MBE. He deserves it. He used to call him Mad Bad Enzo. I don't know why. Dad's my crazy.
Yeah.
MBE. I know it's Dad's not Mad Bad Enzo. Bless him, man. But yeah, he deserved it. You know, he done a lot for boxing. He done a lot in the community, you know. And you see, obviously, his dad, and everybody misses him. You know, I know he's a trainer, but just as a person as well. You know, he's helped everybody out, man. He's done a lot for charity as well. We done a lot for the local community, so we deserved it, you know. So yeah.
Yeah.